Good morning. My name is Mike Reese. I'm the president of the Million Youth Chess Club. Welcome, boys and girls, ladies and gentlemen, to a special edition program. I want to thank Berks Community Television for this opportunity. I'm told they're going to have some exciting news, exciting construction. So this time we're going to have a daytime program, and then it'll be aired at a regular time later in the month. So I'm glad to be here. It's a beautiful late spring day. Summer is almost here. And I want to thank Berks Community Television for working with us and slipping us in this slot and for all that they do. The Million Youth Chess Club, we are members of BCTV, and we encourage everyone to join Berks Community Television and be partners. Now, I love this hat, but sometimes it's a little bit too much, so I'm gonna put this off, but I'm just crazy about chess. You know, first thing I need to do to start the program off is to thank our sponsors. We are successful for the sponsors of many partners, but particularly I have to give a shout out to Berks Community Action Program. Now, I am modeling the new Summer Nights t-shirt. Previously, we've had the Winter Nights t-shirt here. You know, and of course, we have to give credit to Berks Community Action Program, and they do a fine job fighting poverty here in Reading in Berks County. So these t-shirts we use as prizes for our chess events, and we have a bunch of them this summer. You know, we've been blessed to have a variety of partners, and at first I need to thank the Ovid Boys and Girls Club for their partnership, and particularly Miss Deja at the Clinton Street Ovids. On May 9th, we had a wonderful, what I call a chess event. It's a mini chess tournament. We had about 20 kids. We had several kids from other clubs, and we had a great time. And with the sponsorship, the extra money that Berks Community Action Program provides us, we're able to give away t-shirts, trophies, medals, and have some snacks for the kids at all our events. So it's a great partnership with BCAP and the Ovid Boys and Girls Club. So special thanks to the Clinton Street Ovid staff and BCAP for that. That was our last event, and that kind of closed out our winter program. We've been very fortunate to have great relationships most of the year with the Ovid Boys and Girls Club. We start in late September, early October, and we go to Memorial Day. So now, the first few weeks of June, I'm on vacation, and we're going to come back with Summer Chess the week of June 19th. And during that week, we'll have several partnerships. The Ovid Boys and Girls Club, once again, will be at all six of their sites. The Powell, the Clinton Street, Oak Brook, Muhlenberg, I know I'm forgetting a couple here, and others at the Ovid Boys and Girls Club, Glenside, and Pandora, of course. Those six clubs, you know, will be at all their sites this summer, and I want to thank all the directors of those clubs. We've set the dates, we set the times, and if your children go to the Ovid Boys and Girls Club, they may be eligible to participate in chess club. Each club has their own formula of what they want to do. They tend to pick the older kids, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, to play chess. So hopefully, if your children are at the Ovids, they'll have an opportunity to play chess, all six of the Ovid Boys and Girls Club. You know, we have one flyer to show, and that's the blacktop basketball. This is Chess in the Park. This is our 14th year, and where does the time go? I just don't know where the time went, but we've been doing blacktop chess by the Blacktop Basketball League. Here, there's hundreds of young and old alike, boys and girls, men and women, you know, parents, grandparents, coming out to play basketball and to watch their family and loved ones play basketball. And we are located right under the trees near the concession stand. We'll be there. Now, this is weather permitting because we are out in the elements. We'll be there Wednesdays and Thursdays starting June 21st and 22nd from 6 to 8 p.m. And depending on the day and the weather, often we stay later than 8 p.m. because we have enough daylight. So if the weather cooperates and we have players there, we'll stay later. So we start at 6 p.m. Wednesday and Thursday, June 21st and 22nd. Hope to see you there. Free chess, open to the entire public. Come one, come all. And with the support of BCAP, we're able to provide light refreshments, some bottled water, maybe some Gatorade, maybe some pretzels, something to nibble on while you're playing chess. Nice opportunity for parents while they're waiting for their children to play or waiting to pick them up. Get a nice opportunity. And for those kids who don't play basketball, to play chess. But come one, come all, Blacktop, it'll be our 14th year. And again, thank you to Berks Community Action Program for your sponsorship. You know, this summer, again, not only will be at the Ovid Boys and Girls Club starting the week of the 19th, we'll be at the 21st Century Program. Now, when I showed up back in 2003, we had a strong relationship with the 21st Century Program after school in the Reading School District. And most of that was in the elementary schools. As it evolved over the years and the funding changed, it kind of moved towards middle school, the intermediate school, and the high school. So this summer we'll be at several of the middle schools, Northeast, Northwest, Southern middle schools. We'll also be at the Citadel, which is the intermediate high school, and we'll be back at Reading High in the summer program. Now this is designed just for those students in these programs. But I want to thank Ms. Dolores. She's the grant administrator for this 21st Century Program grant. And we want to thank you for your cooperation and sponsorship. And we partner with BCAP to get those little extra goodies, the trophies, the medals, the t-shirts, the prizes, and the occasional snacks. So thank you again for the 21st Century Program. We're looking forward to a very strong summer program. You know, for the very first time, we've had an organization called City Lights. They have an after-school program. They're not affiliated with the Ovitz or the Reading Rec Center. They're more affiliated with a church, a faith-based community, and we see this as a great opportunity. There's so much need in the community to mentor young people, and especially during that critical period of time, the few hours after school between 3 and 6, 4 and 7, those times where it's still daylight, parents aren't always at home, a lot of opportunity for children to go down the wrong path. And City Lights is right in my own neighborhood near the Amanda Stout School at South 10th and Spruce Street. Want to thank Pastor Joe for reaching out to us in April. And now once a week we have a chess program at City Lights. So this was really our first after-school program in the faith-based community, and we want to thank you for your leadership, Pastor Joe. And we'll be doing a program there in the summer. And that's basically designed for the neighborhood kids on the south side of town who come to that program. So thank you, Pastor Joe. You know, I want to thank Heather Boyer and your entire staff at the Reading Rec Commission. Part of the grant that we received from BCAP allows us to visit several of the city rec playgrounds, including but not limited to 11th and Pike, 3rd and Spruce, Bear Park, Hillside, Pandora, and others. There's a couple I think I'm missing, but I'll be visiting them to give everyone a chess lesson. you know, something different, you know, maybe they can pick up some tips. You know, some kids just need to have a refresher to take it to the next level. But I learned chess when I was young, and once you learn the six pieces, as we have here, that these are all math skills. So math, science, technology, computer, they're all that same category, that same discipline. And so, you know, by young people being exposed to these different techniques to enforce their thinking, their analytical reasoning, is very helpful to them. And that's why these programs are really enjoy us, and we enjoy being there. You know, we have this little flyer that I need to share occasionally. I don't always share this at our programs, but the benefits of learning and playing chess. You know, so some of the programs I'll go to, I'll play chess, and people think, well, what, you know, why play chess? You know, what's the big deal? Well, the science has been done. Chess is child's play. It's a book by Laura Sherman and Bill Kilpatrick. Chess is child's play is the name of the book. And just to give you a few reasons why the Million Youth Chess Club, why we do what we do, and while it's so well received, particularly in the last 14 years, is because chess makes kids smarter. Chess gives children problem-solving skills. Chess helps children plan for unwanted surprises. And particularly as adults, we know unwanted surprises happen all the time. And I'll tell you, ladies and gentlemen, I had a chess club last night, and a 16-year-old, he got the advantage. He beat me last night. Doesn't happen often, but the fact is, it was very much an unwanted surprise. He got a move on me. I had a fight from behind. I wasn't able to pull it off. It was a great game, but at the end, he won. And I used it as a learning moment. It's like, this is why we play chess, because things turn quickly. Now, I beat him 2 out of 3 games, but he still got me the one game. So all the time, we need to think before we move, because surprises will always happen in our entire life. Chess gives children the ability to think ahead. Now here, most of our kids are preteen, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, most of them. And I think of, you know, when I drive a car, about the ability to think ahead. You approach an intersection, you approach whether it's a light or a stop sign, you know, what's going to happen here at this intersection? You see a ball rolling across the street. Is a child going to follow that ball into the street? You know, when it's raining, the conditions, snowing, you know, the stopping time, you know, how fast am I going for conditions? But, you know, a 10-year-old isn't thinking that way. But you plant the seed and give them the tools early, it'll be better to think ahead. Chess gives children self-confidence. Chess teaches children to think outside the box. And I saw that last night with my opponent last night. He was thinking outside the box, and he got a good move on me. And so I can see that in some of my students. Chess teaches children how to win and lose graciously. That's the one thing we insist on, is that after every game, you shake hands, good sports in life, you win some, you lose some, let's move on. I think it's a very important concept, and I think that's a real good idea. Winning and losing is great. We don't do the happy dance because we won. Of course, it's nice to be happy, but you know, we want to win graciously, and we want to lose without throwing the pieces too. So there's a balance. Chess gives children the ability to create their own possibilities. Chess gives children the ability to concentrate for extended periods. Our chess clubs are about an hour. Takes a few minutes to set up, takes a few minutes to clean up. You know, if we get 30, 40 minutes for kids to concentrate, that's a good thing. I know that's a good thing for me as an adult, if I can focus for 45 minutes. So it serves me well to focus on what's right in front of me for an extended period of time. And extended may not be hours, it just may be a half hour, 45 minutes, but very good. Because a lot of these kids at these playgrounds and rec centers, they're always active. Basketball, volleyball, four squares, dodgeball, kickball, always moving around. And the idea of sitting down at a table and focusing is a big shift for them. Chess builds teamwork within children. Chess inspires children to tackle difficult tasks. You know, and I know that just for example, just using the program I had last night on the game I lost last night, yeah, I didn't make it easy. Yeah, I play to win against every opponent, doesn't matter their age, and so I don't make it easy. So he earned that victory last night. But the two games that he lost, you know, I didn't make it easy on him either and made it difficult. And so he was able to, you know, fend off the attack until, you know, to the end. But that whole idea is, you know, we don't give up real quick. You know, we keep thinking, think outside the box. Maybe if I do that, maybe it's not what I really want to do, but maybe if I do that, maybe I have a better advantage down the road. I can't predict what he's going to do or my opponent's going to do. So those are the reasons that we teach chess. We encourage kids to play chess. And I know some parents are not on board with that. You know, they didn't have this experience when they were growing up, so they don't know the benefits of chess. So, you know, we really appreciate our listening, viewing audience, watching us, and maybe taking down some notes. You know, the idea that we do have Blacktop, that's free. We teach young and old alike, and it really doesn't take long. 15 minutes, you're playing chess. I mean, that's really all it takes. There's only six different pieces, and in our a program, we often use this 100 easy checkmates. Now, once our students understand how to move the six different pieces and have an idea of how to win the game, we stretch them by arranging the pieces in such a way, as the book suggests, how to checkmate the opponent. In this book, we use one move wins and two move wins, particularly. They're very popular. So once the student learns how to move the pieces, has an idea of what needs to be done to checkmate, we set the pieces up in such a way that white wins in one move. And then we have little slips of paper. They use the letters and numbers as a grid to indicate where the piece moves to, and the winner gets a prize. Usually the medal. I usually give trophies out if they get a two-move puzzle because they're definitely harder. But it gives the student an opportunity to stretch themselves and like a crossword puzzle. Some people are much better at crossword puzzles. I'm not real good at crossword puzzles, but some people are real good at crossword puzzles. But so everyone has a different skill set. And so we want to have people playing each other, good sports, but then again, we have the opportunity of puzzles. So we use puzzles in all our locations at some point, and just want to give that an opportunity. You know, I always want to thank our partners at Juvenile Probation. We have two juvenile probation sites. These, of course, are closed to those clients. One at the Dream Program, Ms. Ware, thank you for your partnership. That's held at the PAL. That's once a week at the PAL. We'll have a program there twice a month this summer. And we have a juvenile probation site at the Evening Reporting Center. That's ERC. And Mr. Manny, we want to thank you for your partnership. That's a year-round program, and you know, we really appreciate what you do there. And here, these are teenagers. This population is newer and older. And sadly, they are already in the criminal justice system. So when we talk about think before you move, and that every move you make in life has a consequence, sometimes good, sometimes bad. So think first, maybe think twice before you move. You know, if you hang out with the wrong crowd and you do what they do, you may get what they get. And sometimes it's not very pretty. So especially at the ERC, we really try to emphasize that idea of take your time, concentrate, think before you move. You know, there's always options. Again, I want to thank all our partners, you know, the Berks community, television, and our special anonymous friend who financially sponsors this bi-monthly program. Every other month, the even months, we're here the fourth Thursday of the month, and this is a special program here. So, you know, we really appreciate the partnership from our special friend. We appreciate Mr. Lowry, Miss Jody, and the entire BCAP staff for what you do to help us get the grant money so we can continue this work in the community. We really are successful because of folks like you. You know, this summer, once again, if we could put the flyer up one more time, please, of the 14th annual Chess in the Park. Come one, come all. Wednesdays and Thursdays. So it's my understanding that the practice has been Monday and Wednesday, there's certain age groups, and Tuesdays and Thursdays, there's other age groups. So when we decide Wednesdays and Thursdays, that will cover all the age groups. And so the parents, grandparents, and the general public, this is one of the things that we are committed to for the last 14 years, because it's completely open to the public and it's free. You know, we'll have some bottled water, maybe some pretzels, maybe some nuts, maybe whatever. So light refreshments. This is really our only site that we can do that. The other sites, the Otter Boys and Girls Club, the Reading Rec, the Juvenile Probation, the City Lights, basically those sites are closed to that population. Now we do have, and I'll have a quick shout out in the last few minutes that I have here, I want to have a quick shout out to our partners at the Reading Library. We have the main Reading Library twice a month on Mondays. We have the Northeast Library, which is a brand new site in partnership with BCAP, every Monday. Now we're off a few Mondays until the summer program starts. And then we have a year-round program at the Southeast Library, which is on Wednesdays. So please check out our website. You know, that too is under construction, but you can always contact us at www.millionyouthchessclub.org. And my number, my home number, which is in the book, Mike Reese, 610-373-3061. So finally, you know, I want everyone to have a happy and a safe, enjoyable summer. You know, shout out to all our partners, our supporters, the BCAP, Ovitz, City Lights, the City Rec, the Juvenile Probation, the Reading Public Library, Blacktop. I want to have a big shout out to all our partners. Have a safe and wonderful summer, and I'll see you next time. Thank you.